to them that in the latter times shall dwell in the world, because they have walked in great pride. Well, understand thou for thyself, and seek out the glory for such as be like thee. Brothers that are seeking wisdom and knowledge and understanding, that's the few, again. You know, that's the few that are laboring. For unto you is paradise open. The tree of life is planted. The time to come is prepared. Goodness was made ready, the seed is built, and rest is allowed gate. Perfect goodness and wisdom. The root of evil is sealed up from you. Weakness and the moth is hid from you, and corruption is fled into hell to be forgotten. Sorrow is past, and in the end is shown the treasures of immortality. And therefore ask thou no more questions concerning the multitude of them that perish. All right? So this is beautiful, man. I don't think, sit back thinking for a moment that what we're doing is awful game for nothing, man. There's a reward coming, you know? And that reward is going to give those that are rich in faith. Now, be rich in faith, man, is that faith. What other better way to show your faith toward you, how much you're outside, get out there and labor, man. Get out there and do some work, man. And do some fishing and wake up men. That's the greatest love you can have. And the greatest love and fear that you can have for your how much you're outside. Get out there and show it. Labor, work. So 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, ends with this here. For corruption must put on incorruption, this mortal must put on mortality. So when the corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the same that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. You know, because I can, it trips me out. I sit back and think of my youth. Great athletic abilities I had. Great abilities I had. Running, jumping. Examples of strength, you know. It's check it out. It ain't really nothing to brag or weird. What we're doing in our lifetimes is nothing compared to the great men of the past, like King David and the mighty men. But just an example of how it was here. You know, it's an upper 95%. 97% of men on this earth can't bench press 200 pounds. And always the goal for getting to the gym is to get to that 225, right? You gotta remember, majority, 97% of men can't even bench press 200 pounds. 175 pounds, can't even do 175 pounds. Imagine the position you put in yourself to be able to do 225 one time. Imagine it doing it 30-something times. You know, well, we got done example of great things, you know, and like now, we're no longer those men. We're up in age, we do this, given this filthy world, and again, which is a good thing. It's not a bad thing, it's a good thing. Like the scripture said, present your body as a living sacrifice. We present and we dedicate our lives to serving the Lord, you know. The hell with being a bad motherfucker. Hell with that shit, man. Hell with that shit, huh? I mean, it was a nice thought. It was nice to be able to run forever up and down hills without being tired, man. But this is of this world. What's to come is that's nothing compared to what's to come, man. Immortality, man. Being God. Being able to take flight. Being able to travel from one planet to the next planet. Well, we're about to receive our inheritance of being gods, man. You know, having our own personal UFO, our own personal chariot. Because, you know, the Israelites, we like to travel. Just, we show examples, we show characteristics of those gods in this world. Man, we like to travel. We like having a nice car. We like having nice gear. We like shining. We like having multiple women. But we're to serve the Lord. We're serving the Lord, man. You know? So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the same that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, yes, hell, grave. Hell, they have turned into some mythical shit. They have turned into some madness, man. some shit that's gonna, you're gonna burn in heaven forever, man. We've seen nothing scriptural about that. They can't go in the scriptures and prove that false doctrine. You know? No grave. Where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin. And the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to the power which giveth us the victory through our Lord Yahushua the Messiah. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Always laboring, man. Looking for information, reading information. We're always laboring, man. You know? So therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Unmovable. Meaning, man, I ain't gonna wake up and be no goddamn Muslim. I'm talking about some goddamn Allah Wakbar. Whatever the hell that bullshit is. Allah Wakbar. Or some goddamn Buddhist. Buddhist is a jackpot. You know? You ain't gonna see me waking up one motherfucking day, Lord, running through the spirit, you know, taking away his spirit. That's a prayer, too. I actually got that prayer written down, him not taking away his spirit from us. That's a beautiful prayer, too. Lord, willing, I don't wake up, he'll wake me up one day and send me to fucking church on my, yes, Jesus and shit. You got, what the hell? What? That's a horrible, scary thought, man. That's a scary thought. And I am not exaggerating the least bit. That's a scary fucking thought to have. Waking up, you back in the world and shit. Chasing women. Getting burnt. Sending your ass to the free clinic. Your woman's sucking on every time, dick and hair, and you still love her. Shit. You know, you praying, dropping to your knees to some fucking Semiramis and Tammuz. That's the mother and child shit. That, you know? Unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, Yahweh. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in Yahweh, it's not in vain, man. You know? So, Lord willing, we know we're those men. Lord willing, we're those men that's going to inherit all these things that these scriptures speak of. The things speak of, the things that are written in this book, man. Give me a second here. Written in this book. Brother didn't show up today, but I'm sure he's going to call me, man. Look like. Let me do some of this here. Let's see what's going on today.
Informed, edified, and influenced. Ever turn back to the Lord, all right? So again, I would give all praise, honor, and glory to the Halbush and Yahweh Shabbat, and the Cup of God. Double honors to our apostles of Great Millstone, elders of GMS. And again, salutation, peace, and much blessing to your hopeful elect. Peace. Stay prayed up. Stay prayed up until the end. You know? So, water. Shalom.